We live in a cesspool, a septic tank, a gigantic sewage complex in which runs the dregs, the filth, the misery-laden slop, the race of men, his hatreds, his prejudices, his passions, and his violence. And the keeper of the sewer? Man. He is a scientifically advanced monkey who walks upright and with eyes wide open into an abyss of his own making. His bombs, his fallout, his poisons, his radioactivity, everything he designs as an art for dying is his excuse for living. No, Harvey, we live in an exquisite bedroom, an insanity. Maybe all the more grotesque by the fact that we don't recognize it as insanity. Ultimately, somebody pushes a button, and just as ultimately, this earth disappears. For living. And just as ultimately this earth disappears.
Did it ever occur to you that some of these scientifically advanced monkeys make bombs as a simple expedient for survival? That across this planet there are other scientifically advanced monkeys who would pulverize us into dust if they thought they could do so with impunity?
All of this, I suppose, is right and practical and expedient. Few germs will rise up out of the rubble. Wave microscopic flags of victory, shed a few microscopic tears, race of men. Are you content with this kind of status quo? Are you satisfied with this kind of 20th century? Insanity. Ultimately, somebody pushes a button.